Good morning. My name is Abe Davis, Operations Section Chief with the Alaska Green Incident Management Team. And I'm going to give you your daily update for Friday, July 1st. So, starting out, we'll start up here on the north end of the fire, up north on fire 206. Yesterday, we had red flag conditions across the fire area for hot, dry, windy conditions. Did not see a whole lot in the way of activity to report on this fire. So happy to report that between the Biomute all the way out to Stony River, all of those communities and associated infrastructure, all that's looking really good right now. I'm not anticipating any movement towards those values in the next 24, 48 hours. Let's go ahead and zoom back out here a little bit. Working to the east, did see some activity on the northern flank of fire 197 and 198. A little bit of a westerly movement there, and we're continuing to monitor that today. Also yesterday, we saw a really active day up on fire 228. We had a couple of members of the Wainema hotshots in there the last couple of days. Further up, we had discussed in yesterday's update, looking at doing some burnouts around a couple of cabin sites in there to try and button operations up on that far northeastern portion of the fire. They were successful in putting fire in there the night before last, and they spent yesterday mopping up and securing around those cabin sites. They'll be in there for another day today, and we'll be looking at kind of buttoning up operations up in that area. As we work back down towards Lime Village, really active day yesterday. South and west of Lime Village, had six fire bosses working that fire's edge last night, just trying to keep things in check there so they don't get in alignment and make a push at the village. But we are happy to report that structure preparation in and around the village and associated cabins along the Stony River, the prep was completed on that yesterday. So the crews today are just making sure that all those different plumbing systems are operational and taking advantage of the time we have to kind of pre-treat fuels and just be prepared if that fire does make any movements today. I guess the biggest story for yesterday come down to the south here to fire 228 along the Mulchatna River drainage and Cuctuli drainages. That fire was extremely active yesterday, and we also started to see some activity back on 205. We did implement structure protection measures along the Mulchatna River at several cabin sites. And we did even have some contact with some local lodge owners in there yesterday. You know, firefighters are engaged in there, and there's areas where we can safely have folks, and there's other areas where we need to kind of clear out. And so we'll continue to anticipate another active day in there today. And we'll take measures as appropriate to try and protect all those sites that have been pre-planned and pre-plumbed. We do have another red flag warning over across the fire area today. We're expecting those same strong southerly winds. We're also anticipating hot, dry conditions. So we anticipate a repeat of yesterday's fire behavior. Also, good thing to remind folks here, we still have the temporary flight restriction in place out here over the Mulchatna, the fires in the Mulchatna River drainage. That TFR is going to extend slightly to the north. That has extended slightly to the north, excuse me. And also just, you know, a lot of fire activity on the ground yesterday, a lot more today anticipated. That's just going to put a lot more smoke up into the interior. And obviously that's having impacts on us and our ability to fly, as well as other operations in the state. We do have warnings in effect today for lightning in the central and eastern interior, as well as for tomorrow. So across the state, we've got a pretty heavy workload we're trying to manage amongst the different fire management agencies. And also with that, I think it would be good to mention that effective at midnight tonight, there'll be a statewide burn closure taking effect. And so folks need to make sure they're aware of that, certainly going into the holiday weekend. So with that concludes today's update. We'll talk to you all tomorrow.